Somewhere, within the nest of this ant colony, there lives an unknown and weird-looking queen ant. Her gaster is bloated like a balloon, with capacity to lay hundreds of eggs. And she is the sole egg layer of this colony. Now, without any further delay, let's start the video. For that we have to go in past, exactly a week ago. So, I found this ant colony under one of my plant pots, and being an antkeeper I kidnapped the whole colony. After collecting the colony I gave them a test tube which they're in currently. But this colony is having a good amount of workers. So I decided to give them one of my DIY ant nest, as it would be very hard to keep them inside this test tube for a long time. This formicarium has four entrances which I can open as the colony grows larger in numbers. If you also want to make this type of formicarium, you can watch my tutorial video on how to make one. I have just opened the smallest chamber for now, and the rest of the chambers are closed currently, because the colony is not too big to occupy other chambers. So to move this colony I connected their test tube with the tubing of the formicarium with some cotton. As soon as I connected the test tube with the formicarium, the workers immediately started exploring the outworld, and the workers also started exploring the nest area very quickly. And they even started moving into the nest after some hours of exploring. After they fully moved into the nest, I disconnected their old test tube and gave them their first meal under my care. Here is how the colony looks after they completely moved into it, but this time, when I gave a closer look to their queen, she looked very weird to me and not like a normal pheidole queen. So I began to research about her, and after some chatting with some ant experts, I tried to identify her, and I came with a conclusion that she is not a normal queen. Instead, she can either be a parasitic queen, which means she is not the original queen of the colony, and she have killed the original queen of this pheidole colony and took the place of that queen to lay eggs. This would have been done before I caught them. Or she could also be an inquiline queen. Inquiline queen, you may ask. Inquiline queen ants are somewhat similar to parasitic queens, but the difference is that when they enters inside a host colony, they do not kill their original queen and lay the eggs along with the original queen of that host colony. But after those eggs of the inquiline queen will hatch, they will not hatch into workers. Instead, those eggs laid by the inquiline queen will hatch into alates, so inquilines don't produce workers at all. And after those alates will hatch, they will mate and again fly out of that host colony and find a new host colony to again lay eggs. And this cycle continues. Inquiline queens don't harm their host colony, but they will just use their resources to develop their alates. But in my case, I don't have a real, or you can say, the host queen which will lay eggs that will hatch into workers, which is the main problem, because if she becomes to be an inquiline queen, then all her eggs will hatch into alates and no workers will be produced at all in the future, which will ultimately lead to the colony's death. There are also possibilities of mutations and maybe discovering a new species, but the chances are very less. We will only get to know the truth after the second generation of eggs will hatch. If they hatch into alates, then she is an inquiline queen, but if they hatch into workers, then we have many possibilities to go, so fingers crossed that she is not an inquiline. Thanks for watching. If have any queries or want to talk with me or any fellow antkeepers, you can join my Discord server. The link is in the description box below, and as always, like and subscribe for more content.